Whoa. Oh, hey, and welcome back from our 1948 film, The Devil's Cargo.
We find ourselves today here in Akron, Ohio at Devil Strip Dolly's.
And not one of these dolls around here look anything like me.
Well, thank God for small favors.
Oh, I would appreciate it if you wouldn't swear at me like that.
Oh, and Dave is still having conversations with his invisible friend.
He is not invisible, and he is not my friend.
Oh, that's like stabbing me in the heart. If I had a heart.
So, Dave, you're telling me you're having a discussion with a visible friend that nobody else can see who's not your friend.
Sounds kind of silly when you say it like that.
Well, do you really want me to say that you're talking to the devil? He's right here and you can see him?
Why not? The devil talks to everyone. But usually only lawyers and Wall Streeters listen.
Oh, well, anyway, there's been some question about the origin of the Falcon character, and it seems like the first Falcon on film appeared in 1941 at the RKO Studios, where they were looking for a replacement for their successful series, The Saints.
Now, the Falcon had a total of 16 films in the series, and the first Falcon movie starred George Sanders as the first Falcon. Now, he incidentally was also RKO Studios' The Saint. And his Falcon name was Gay Lawrence.
Movie studio heads used to list me all the time. Now all they do is make sequels.
Well, George Sanders only played the Falcon for 3 movies, and then he passed the role off to his real-life brother, Tom Conway. Now, Tom appeared in the Falcon, and his first Falcon movie was called The Falcon's Brother, and that Falcon's name was Tom Lawrence.
Actors used to listen to me all the time.
Now, Tom would play the Falcon character for 10 films before RKO Studios would drop the series of movies.
I would make sure they would make 100 pictures. Now they only want to make 2 movies a year.
Okay. I don't know who you're talking to, Dave. Anyway, then Film Classic Studios picked up the series, and the Falcon became Mike Watling. And he was that character, he was played by the actor John Culver, who was a magician actor, and he actually did it for 3 movies.
And now actors just want to be in independent films. Half of those don't even make it to the movies. Well, what do they need me for?
Okay, and then there's the radio and the TV syndicated series, but, you know, I think we're going to save that for the next segment, Dave. So, your invisible friend still hanging around?
Julie, well, why can't you believe me when I tell you that I can see and hear the devil standing beside me?
Well, probably because you can see and hear things all the time that nobody else can see and hear, you know. But let's say it's true. Devil's there. I have a question. Do you think you could ask him for me?
Well, sure, go ahead.
Well, I've always heard it said that if you tell a lie, the devil laughs. Is that true?
Well, is it true?
As a matter of fact, that is quite true.
Oh, geez, the big oil company owners must really keep you laughing.
These guys are always good for a few chuckles, but the people who keep me in stitches are the frackers.
Well, while Dave's here busy not talking with his invisible friend, I think we have to take a break, watch a sketch, and then get back to our movie, The Devil's Cargo.
Don't worry, it'll never affect your water. That one always kills me.
We'll be right back.